Monday morning in New Zealand, it's Monday morning in Samoa with a new week beginning, the two-day curfew over and authorities well into an unprecedented mass vaccination campaign to contain that deadly outbreak of measles. The official death toll now stands at 68. And that doesn't include any lives lost overnight. We hope there were none. That's a truly terrible number in a country of just 200,000 people. A total of 4,581 measles cases have been reported to the disease surveillance team, with a further 121 in the 24 hours to yesterday afternoon. In short, the fight back is still a work in progress, although the Samoan government is reporting almost 90% of vaccine coverage has now been achieved. Joining us now from Apia with the latest is our wonderful Pacific correspondent, Barbara Dreaver. Talofalava, Barbara. It's so nice to have you with us, as always.
Talofalava.
It looks like you're in front of the hospital there, is that right? And it looks quite quiet behind you.
Yes, that's right. It looks a deceiving, isn't it? I mean, there's still so many cases inside. I understand there's around 120 cases here, still 17 in intensive care. What you're looking at behind me, John, is actually one of the makeshift ICU tents that have been set up to help take the burden off the main hospital. You know, one thing too is that we talk about 68 dead, and I think there's some concern that may be underreported. And I say maybe because there's the issue that perhaps children or babies have died at home and been buried, and
yes,
those numbers haven't made their way to the authorities. So there's always that possibility too. 68, that number will rise. There's no doubt about that.
And when you think of it on a per capita basis, given that Samoa's population is, slightly less than 5% of New Zealand's, it's just a staggeringly large number. Barbara, and I don't know when the time to have this conversation is, and I know that I saw you raise it with the health spokesperson you had on last week. I thought that was a fascinating interview. But a catch-up is being played on the vaccination campaign. When the measles outbreak began in New Zealand, and it was big in Auckland, and we know how close Samoa and Auckland are, who's let the side down here? Public health figures in New Zealand, public health figures in Samoa, both? Are those conversations taking place, or is it too soon to hear both? Both.
Yeah, no, both. It's not too soon. Both have definitely been responsible for this measles outbreak. And, you know, it's one thing that's come out over the weekend is that in the past, John, way back when, the children would go to through the women's groups to have their vaccinations done, because it is just too hard for many families to find their way down to clinics. We've come across families who have no transportation. They're way up in the WOPS. It's really hard. No phone coverage. So the main thing is, if the government is looking at going back to the traditional ways, there's no doubt about it. The health ministry here has let the side down over the past few years. It's been plunging. The immunisation rate has been plunging. So what they're looking at doing is going back to the churches, going back to work at the old ways of doing things, to get reaching out to communities to make sure these children get vaccinated.
Barb, it does look like, in numerical terms anyway, that the vaccination, that the two-day curfew and the extraordinary push out into communities to take vaccines to people was pretty successful. It's catch up, and of course, if you've already been exposed to measles, the vaccines are no good. But it looks like they did some impressive numbers, Barb.
They absolutely did some impressive numbers. The two-day shutdown was extremely successful. Now, what you have to remember too is that only 85% of children under the age of 5 have been vaccinated for MMR. So that still leaves a vulnerable 15% at risk. And so it's by no means over, and that's why health authorities are still going out. The communications minister, who's also the measles spokesperson, Afa Masanga Riko Tupai, told us that people can still ring up. There's a number that they can ring up, and health authorities will go to them to vaccinate them, and that is crucial.
Bob, one final question, and I know you understand that country so well. You've been there so many times. How is it feeling there? How are they coping? How shell-shocked and stunned and grief-stricken is Samoa?
Oh, yeah, it's next level. The grief here is, you feel it. Pretty much every family in Samoa has someone who has died or has certainly knows someone who has died or has an extended family member who has died. And we are talking babies and preventable deaths. So, yeah, it's certainly next level, and especially with Christmas coming up, it's pretty tough here. But there is this worry too that, okay, we've had the two-day shutdown and now everything's going to be okay. It's not. So there's that feel that we've got to keep going here. Parents, I've been talking to some of the mums over the past few days, and their babies are still in hospital, and the worry is far from over for them.
Thanks, Barbara Dreaver. And that report, I think you filed it on Saturday night when you were out in a fairly remote part of Upolo, the main island, and you were with that was a staggering piece of journalism. You're doing great work up there. Thanks, Barb, and I know you'll be filing for six tonight. We really appreciate it. Barbara Dreaver, our Pacific correspondent. Of course, part of the issue here is anti-vaxxers and the enormous damage they've done in that country with their cynicism and their lies. And Facebook, I think we've got a statement.
We have a statement here.
Because a lot of that work has been done on Facebook.
Yes.
And how the hell are they able to still get away with it?
Well, Facebook said that they are working to remove any misinformation leading to imminent physical harm, including health misinformation claims. They are directing their sort of attention towards hoaxes, like what has been, you know, claimed and identified.
The link to autism.
Hoax.
Yeah.
Hoaxes. But they're struggling with the algorithms because they have to apparently work out what is misinformation and what is just opinion. So they can't just take people's opinions down because it's a public platform for people to put their opinions up, apparently. So it's going to take a while, which is unfortunate.